Galvarino was a legendary warrior of the Mapuche tribe, whose bravery and determination are remembered 500 years after his death. A fascinating character from history, he is often referred to as the real-life Wolverine from X-Men. Why, you may wonder? Let's find out together, right now. The year is 1557, and the long conflict known as the Arauco War is well underway. Spanish invaders driving their ambition of conquest into the land we now know as Chile, being resisted at every turn by the brave Mapuche tribe who call it their home. At the Battle of Lagunillas in south-central Chile, an army of Spanish conquistadors routed several thousand Mapuche Indians, capturing around 150 prisoners. Amongst the imprisoned men was a young chieftain named Galvarino. Along with his men, Galvarino was marched back to the main Spanish encampment where a swift trial took place. But rather than simply execute their prisoners and be done with it, the leader of the Spaniards, Governor Mendoza, ordered instead his men to sever the right hand and nose of each captured warrior and to cut off both hands of the leaders such as Galvarino. Mendoza hoped to end the war early by striking fear into his enemy and forcing the Mapuche to surrender. Little did he know, however, that his foe was not so easily intimidated, and in reality, the war would last for over a century. According to Mapuche legend, Galvarino bravely offered up his hands to be cleaved off, demanding in vain that his captors deliver the killing blow. Whether this is accurate is unclear, but it would certainly not be a surprise given the rest of his story. The mutilated soldiers were released and sent back to their tribe to deliver the intended request for surrender. Reaching their destination, Galvarino was taken to the Mapuche general Caupolican, to whom he was supposed to plead capitulation, but he would do no such thing, instead urging the general to rally their people and fight back against the Spanish invaders. Standing tall before the gathered tribe, he raised his handless arms in the air and spoke clearly and passionately, delivering the words, "My brethren, why have you stopped fighting these Christians? The damage they have done since they entered our realm and what they have done to me is what they will continue to do if we are not diligent in destroying these injurious people." Inspired by the immense bravery of this mutilated young chieftain, Galvarino was named a commander in the Mapuche forces and they began to prepare for war. But Galvarino was not content to merely be the man to rally his people for battle. He was determined to also be the one to lead them. Knowing that he would be useless in a fight given his current state, he took the unbelievable decision to have long, sharp blades fastened to each of his arms, sticking out past the stumps to create two deadly weapons. The real-life Wolverine indeed. This act would transform him into a legend, inspiring his people for centuries to come. What fear he must have struck into the enemy to see a madman charging at them, fire in his eyes and two swords for arms. They began fighting back immediately, and less than a month after his capture and mutilation, Galvarino found himself on the front lines at the Battle of Milarupe. It is said that he entered the battle at the head of the Mapuche army, commanding his men and inspiring them with his words, "My brothers, see that you all fight very well. You do not want to be as I am without hands, so that you will not be able to work nor to eat if you do not give it to them." He raised his transformed arms high into the air to show his men and spoke the words, "Nobody is allowed to flee, but to die, because you die defending your mother country." With that, he charged headfirst into battle, moving quickly past his army and demonstrating once again his unrelenting bravery, declaring loudly that he would happily die first, and though he no longer had hands, he would do what he could with his teeth. Despite their inspirational commander and outnumbering the Spanish forces 2-1, the Mapuche implemented their battle plan poorly. And despite initial success in disrupting the Spanish cavalry, Mendoza was eventually able to bring his cannons to bear and turn the tide of the battle in his favour, quickly routing the Mapuche. When it was done, 3,000 Mapuche had been killed. Only a few hundred survived and were taken prisoner. It is said that Galvarino was able to cut down Mendoza's second-in-command during the battle, and despite his reckless aggression, he found himself amongst the small number of living and a prisoner once again. This time his luck had finally run out, and he was sentenced to death. Records conflict over the manner of his end, some suggesting hanging, whilst others imply that he was thrown to the dogs. Even in this moment, Galvarino did not flinch. and in response to being offered mercy and a chance to join the Spanish side, calmly replied, "I would rather die than live like you. I'm only sorry that my death will keep me from tearing you to pieces with my teeth." A tragic end to the story of Galvarino, but his determination and bravery remained an inspiration for many years to come as the war raged on, the Mapuche resisting Spanish occupation for over a century. Truly, one of the most colourful real-life warriors from history, his image remains a strong and powerful one that speaks as much of his insane dedication to fighting for his homeland as his unwavering bravery. Hey guys, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, don't forget to hit that subscribe button for more great stories. Cheers.